As disciples, we've all grown very close to Jesus. We've learned so much from Him. He's taught us ways that are pleasing to God and how we should live our lives each and every day. We've seen things, how He's taken care of the sick, even more how He raised the dead. Amen? He is so worthy of our praise. I love my Lord. And we all need Him so much. Or at least I think we all do. It seems that Judas is different these days. Somehow or another, he's changed. And I question his motives at times. And the priests and the authorities, I see how they look at my Jesus. I see it in their eyes. I see the hate and the anger. It's an anger I feel. But you know, I love my Lord. He chose me, a simple fisherman, John. And I believe everything he says. I'm with him 100%. But even lately, Jesus is very quiet. As if something were wrong. Today he asked Peter and I to go find somewhere where we could all meet and have supper. He told us to go to town, find the man carrying the water jug, and ask him if we could use his guest room. We did as asked. The room is prepared. The meal is ready. This supper, it must be very important to Jesus. And as I stand before you, I have a heavy heart. Something's wrong. I don't know what it is. But I'm hoping tonight that when Jesus speaks to us, He will explain to us what the future holds. But I fear the worst.
The beer. Tender voice, my What comes next is the rest of the story. The story of the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Some loved Him, some hated Him. He loved each and every one of them just like He does us today. Those soldiers that nailed Him to the cross, they represent us. They were sinners just like us. Even though they beat Him, they spit on Him, they ripped the flesh from His back, they pierced the crown of thorns in His head, they nailed Him to the cross. He died for them, just like He did us. But 3 days later, He arose. He came out of that boring tomb, and He's alive today. And that's what had to take place to make it possible for us to spend eternity with Him in heaven. He said, "Follow me." He asked us to follow Him and make Him Lord of our life. He said, "No one comes to the Father except through me." Don't you want that? Don't you want to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior today? Today is the day of your salvation. Today, you can meet Jesus Christ for the very first time. But it won't be your last.
despise.